No day is complete without the semi-retired foamer.
Howdy everybody. This video is a little bit different, I suppose. It's a look at Toronto back in the final months of it running and a revisit to the same locations today. A little bit more complicated than I've done in the past, so please persevere with this really bad quality one. Perhaps worse than normal. But hope you enjoy. And if you do, please subscribe. I know I don't asked very often, probably just every video, but it really would help if you could. Thanks guys, enjoy, bye bye. Hello people and welcome to Toronto on a freezing cold morning. I'm up here for the day and thought I'd revisit our favourite old Branchline back in the 80s and the very start of the 90s. I would be a regular here. Actually travel on the last trains all afternoon and the actual last train that ran in the 1990. The line opened in 1891, if you're curious about that. Very interesting line with a very interesting history. We're gonna take a look at the terminus, and if I get a chance, we might go further up towards the junction. Enjoy, or not, that's always up to you. We're looking towards the junction of Fassifern. Hey. 146 kilometres from Sydney Central Station, obviously. Toronto's always had probably one of the nicest views of any railway station. Looking out across Lake Macquarie. During this video, I'll be adding some bits of footage I took back just before the line closed. that will be coming up, I would imagine. Remains of an old semaphore signal. See whether the arm's been pinched or otherwise taken somewhere for holding. Track did a small S bend there and went across the now removed level crossing. That crossing would probably stand in the way of any possibility of returning services to the actual station. Let's go back and have a look at the station itself. Quite a vast difference to the last night, back in 1990, when the very last train ran, four-car set to cope with the passengers on offer. This station was full of people, most of them very drunk and having a very good time, despite the sad occasion. If you search my channel, you'll see videos of the last night, or a video of the last night, and the party atmosphere that existed here. We'll be right back.
Fair enough. Yep, opened in 1891, closed in 1990, 1 year short of its 100th anniversary. Bit sad, can wait just one more year. Toronto ended its years as a single line platform coming to a dead end right here. Despite that hill behind, there used to be a railway yard, quite an extensive one, beyond the platform. Loco hauled steam trains would proceed from the station into the yard to run around. And goods would also obviously be handled here. It's very hard to imagine the railway yard being situated here now. The following will be a couple of photos taken by Weston Langford of a steam haul passenger train in the process of running around. Following closure of the line back in 1990, the bus service replaced the trains. That's still a bit noisy. Most of the disgust of the locals. Alas, It's still the case to this day. Lovely. Not half as impressive as a 620 set. Thus endeth our mediocre video about Toronto Station. Now for a squiz around Blackalls Park. Well, once there was three intermediate stations along this branch, if I recall correctly. It ended up being just Blackalls Park as the only station between Fassifern in Toronto. It's getting pretty hard to see the rails in places now.
It was so bad that I'm almost embarrassed to ask you to subscribe, but please do!